this program and the things that we can offer. But I want you to understand, the things that kids have to get better at. You have to get better at handling the basketball and shooting the ball. It's atrocious. The other thing that kids have to do, they have to figure out how to get in the gym and work. You saw this every time that you walk into the gym. Kids pick up a basketball and they shoot it. They don't pick up a basketball and work. And there's a big difference. And one of the reasons that kids struggle in games and team struggles is because kids can't shoot. Coach Dave and I go to games all the time and we're watching kids play. And they just don't know how to shoot because they don't get in the gym and do the things necessary. Now today we're going to show you a lot of techniques that will help you, but it won't matter what I show you if you don't apply what I show you. It makes no difference. We have a group of kids that come to me on a consistent basis on Monday and Wednesdays, and I show them over and over and over what they should be doing and how they should be doing it. But by nature, what do kids do? They do what they want to do, how they want to do it. That's just what they do. You have to understand that you must acknowledge that you need to change, and then you must be willing to make that change, and then you must work on that change in order for your shooting to improve. These are the things that I know. If you get a chance, walk around and you'll walk into the lobby, you'll see state championship pictures, you'll see state championship banners. This is where I coached for 34 years. For 24 years, I was the girls' coach. We won 82% of our games. 44 of my players went to college, 23 were Division I, 6 of my former players were college coaches. That's not to pat me on the back, that's to acknowledge that they did the things necessary so that they could fulfill their dream of playing college basketball. And if you're here, my assumption is that you want to get better at what you're doing, and we're going to show you the things necessary. I had a distinct advantage. Those of you that's ever seen me coach, I don't tolerate mediocrity. I don't accept it. It's not going to be a part of who we are. And so when my kids were here, I had my kids in this gym 6 days a week, and we worked on the things necessary. So I would ask my kids, what is it that you want that you don't have? And my kids would say a championship. Well, what's it going to take to get it? They would say hard work. And I'd say, are you willing to do those things? And they would say yes, and of course we were. Most people didn't play harder. Most people weren't tougher than us. And those are two things that you have to put into your game. You have to play tough. You have to compete at the highest level. And if you add toughness to your game, whatever your game lacks, you can overcome it because you're tough. So we have to do those things. At the end of the session today, I will ask some questions. If you know the answers, I've got some t-shirts that I'm going to give you just for putting things in your think tank. So players and parents, at the end, when I ask these questions again, raise your hand. And if you get it correct, you can get you a t-shirt. There are 5 F's of shooting. Most of you don't know that, but there are 5 F's of shooting. And it goes like this: feet, form, fingers, follow through, focus. And I can just about tell you, every time a kid shoots, they're missing one of the 5. And that's why they struggle. If you go and look at the NBA statistics, Curry's shooting almost 50% from the 3-point line. And most of them aren't 3s, they're 5s. I mean, he's shooting out there. Got it? When he was a freshman, he didn't make the varsity team at Charlotte Latin. He's 5'7", 130 pounds. But he decided he was going to do all the things necessary to be as good as he could be, and he got in the gym and did those things. So if you see him play, watch his feet, watch his follow through, watch his focus. So once again, parents and players, feet go forward, forearm goes forward, fingers go forward. What's next? Follow through and focus. And most kids lack focus. Most kids shoot the ball to shoot it. They don't shoot the ball to score. There's 3 elements of the R's that's going to help you become a better shooter. Release, rotation, results. I can go watch Brooke shoot a basketball and I can just about tell you from the stands whether or not it's going in by the way she holds that basketball. Your child's rotation should never change in the course of a game. And I can watch kids shoot, and it'll change 4 and 5 times in the course of the game. That means that they're holding the ball wrong, and the release is different each time they shoot. But if you put your thumb on the inside, and you get this finger on the inside, you will always have the perfect rotation. So it's release, rotation, and results. And if you play in my program and you shoot it wrong, I hope you miss it. Because I can't educate you and teach you if everything that you do is wrong and you have success in it. Make sense? We got to do things right. Because this is an epidemic that happens everywhere. If you walk into a gym at a rec game or a middle school, as soon as a kid touches a ball, what does everybody do? Shoot it. And guess what that kid does? They shoot it. And it's the worst thing that they can do. True story, I'm coaching right over there, and my kid comes down the court, and the mom yells, shoots it, and the kid shot it. Have a seat. And I turn to her and the mother. You can play for me or play for her, but you can't play for both. And you get to choose, because I'm in charge. Well, the kid decided to listen to me, and she gets a scholarship, and she ends up being a college coach, because she stopped listening to the parents. Don't misunderstand. Listen to parents if the things you're supposed to. But parents, as a parent, you got to stop telling your kid to shoot because it may not be the shot they need to take. That makes sense to you? So we have to teach you the things that you need to do, and that's one of them. Whether you're on offense or defense, you're only as good as your feet. When my kids get the basketball, when their feet get ready, I know they're going to be ready. So whether you're on offense or defense, you're only as good as your feet. The better your footwork, the better player you become. If you get beat on defense, it's usually you got beat because your feet weren't in position. If you shoot poorly with the basketball, it's usually because your feet weren't in position. So once again, you're only as good as your feet. When you catch the ball on the catch, dip forward. So when you catch the ball, dip forward. Your shoulders should never go back. Your eyes should never go back. Your chin should never go up. So another term, when you catch it, catch, dip, and then let's move forward. And we're going to show you all of these things. If you hold it wrong, Nicole, you shoot it wrong. And kids have a tendency to hold the ball wrong. When they get it, their hand is on the outside rather than the inside. So if you hold it wrong, you're going to shoot it wrong. Let's see, where's Brooke? Brooke, don't take shots that you can take. Take shots that you can make. But kids take shots just to take them. Take shots that you can make. We have a rule in my program. If you can't make 70% of your shots with no one guarding you, you shouldn't shoot. Because statistically in a game, you're going to go down 40%. So if you're making 40% of your shots in practice, statistically you're going to shoot zero in a game. Now we all know this, a blind squirrel finds a nut and a drunk driver gets home. We know this. But our thing is to help you do the things necessary on a continuous basis so that they get better at those skills. And if you start taking shots that you can make, all of a sudden the game gets easier, you get better, and it's easy for me to sell, because we already know this. If you can shoot the basketball, you're going to get playing time. If you can shoot it great, you're going to get scholarships. It just happens that way. We already know this, whether you're a Duke fan or not. The reason they're as good as they are right now is because Luke Kennard is shooting it phenomenal. And that's enabling them to make plays when they have to make plays. And it's not so much the rebound. It's not so much the pass. It's the ability to make shots. And he's making those shots. If you are moving toward the basketball, you should hop on the catch. If you are moving toward the basketball, you should hop on the catch. If you are standing, you should step. And we're going to do all of those things today. So parents, at any time when we do all of this stuff, if you feel the need to come down there and do all of that, please jump in and do it. We'll have kids demonstrating. You're not going to get in our way, so you go down there and do the things necessary. So, kids, if we'll go downstairs, I need you to get a basketball, and there's four lines on the volleyball court, and you get to one of those four. Come here, baby. Put your hair close to the top. Sarah's going to go this way. She's going to dribble with her left hand. She's going to move her right hand. Right here, facing this way. Right hand. Just like we do with two basketballs, you're going to one. Outside hand dribbles, right foot moves. Pound. Pound. And stay. You want to get your hips low. You want to pound that basketball. Keep it tight in the bottom. And your feet got to move. Coach, count this line. Top of 3, 2, 4, 6. crossover coach. We call this empty out. She'll circle out.
Sarah, I'll be sure this is going to be your mask. You get right here. You're going to stop. You got it real quick.
Go hard. Go hard.
Get around the first crossover. That's it before. Slip. Crossover.
It's good.
Coaches, you got it there. Put right here. Also, we got to go. 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 Go
best reflection upon the program in which they play. You should not be tired. Because I want you to understand this. Great players don't get tired. Great players don't get tired. Great players beat good players because the good players got tired. If you watch the ACC and watch the absolute best players, they're going to play somewhere between 36 of the 40 minutes. So your kid has to be conditioned. If she is that player on your team, she has to stay on the floor and she has to be able to perform through fatigue. Most kids won't find out if they can get to that point, they give up way before. Now, we're getting ready to do some form shoot basketball. Now, we're going to put three at a basket. So that puts 16, let's see, we got six. That's going to put 18 players there. So, Joy, if you would, right here. Now, this is a great way to find out if your kids aim small, miss small. So you should be right here. Who's my other player? JC? JC's going to be right here. Okay? And Brooke's going to be right here. Now, if you're watching your child, one of the things that you should do as a player, if you guys are pressing, stand up, don't be any stuff. I know you do that because somebody allows you to do it, but you never have to do that here. Because that wall's been here since 1957, and you got to hold it up. Y'all all catch it. Okay, true that. True that. Okay, if Joy does everything correct, he's going to have his left arm behind his back. He's going to bring this basketball and so that his thumb is near the forearm, I mean the eyebrow. And his target is that metal bar, and Joy shoot it, and you should hit it, and it should come back. Snap it, don't push it. Snap it with your wrist, like that. Keep doing that. Very good. Now, when you watch your child, most kids won't hit that. They'll miss it, which means they're missing those same type of shots in the game. And JC, the same thing on this side, dip, snap with the finger. Snap it, dip, dip, snap the fingers. There you go, dip, snap the fingers. And stay, if you're watching from there, at the point of release, keep going up. Her forearm will get past her forehead and then she releases it. Most kids shoot with their elbow too low and they shoot flat. Now Brooke is going to bounce the basketball with her right hand, left hand, right hand behind her back. She's gonna bounce it, get under it, come up and switch. Hit it, come up, switch. Very good. Now, that's what she's doing. She's trying to get control of the basketball, bounce it, channel the rim, come up, and switch. Your child should be working these skills all the time, and when they do it, you want to get 25, 25, and 25 to do those things. Sarah, if you live out here real quick, please, who else comes to work with me on some basis? That's kid ends up playing competitive basketball, I'm going to tell you this right away. If your child walks through drills, you need to transfer your child out of that school because that coach is not helping you. You should never have a situation where you're walking on the court. Does anyone know who gets to walk? Who gets to walk? The mailman. Raise your hand if you're a mailman. Otherwise, you don't get to walk. You are. You don't get to walk. You have to work. Now, if you would please right here, Sarah. Now, while these kids are doing this, those with the basketball, tennis ball are going to be doing this. You're going to bounce it and cross it. Bounce, cross, catch. Jada, here we go. Bounce it. Come on, let's go. Let's go. Bounce it. Bounce it, cross, catch. Come on. Bounce it, cross, catch. Good, Jada. Bounce it, cross, catch. Bounce it, cross, catch. Bounce it, cross, catch. Bounce it, cross, catch. And stay. Now, Jada is going to bounce, step, catch. Jada. Bounce it, step. Sir, real quick. Bounce it, step, catch. Bounce, step, catch, and stay. Now, all of these drills are designed so that you get better with the basketball. So, if they get better with the basketball, they're going to get better as a shooter, as a driver, as a scorer. Okay? So, here's what we want to do. Get in groups of three. And there's six baskets. Got it? Those of you who don't get one of the six, you'll be in the middle, and we're rotating every 30 seconds. Now, parents, one of the things you should do for your child, hold the basketball. is kids don't like to do first things first. They like to do the next thing first. So what is the first thing we're going to do? Is bounce that basketball. Kind of got it?
Bounce that basketball.
Jacob, real quick, bounce the basketball. Yep. Keep it bouncing. That's the first thing. Then we're going to bounce the tennis ball. Now we're going to cross it away. Most of these kids in the circle, we're trying to do both at the same time. So bounce the basketball. Bounce the tennis ball. Cross the basketball, catch it. If you say it in your mind, bounce it, cross it, catch it. And that'll work. Bounce it, cross it, catch it. Ready? Logically impossible for it not to happen if these two fingers work. So we got to do that, and you should be getting about 20 reps in while you're doing this. You guys should be getting 40 to 50 reps in 30 seconds. Now we're going back to step. Take it one more time. Back to step. Quick hands. If you notice, the basketball is always below the knees, and that's where you should handle the ball. Ready? Go. most of you right here, we bounce, cross, step. Jordan, really quick, show me off. Catch it, bounce it, reach it higher. Quick feet, quick feet, quick feet. Here we go, work it. Takes 10,000 to master. You guys have been here less than an hour. But I know this to be a fact. As soon as we start shooting again, they will start back doing the things that creates the inability to shoot the basketball. If in your high school environment, you're not shooting 50% of your shots, you shouldn't take those shots. You have to get better at shooting the basketball. And here's the other thing we just said. Thumb to the eyebrow. Most kids have the basketball right here. Now I tell the kid to get it to their eyebrow. They went this way. If you don't know anatomically where your eyebrow is, it's gonna be tough. You gotta figure these things out. Now I want you to get with a partner, somebody that you can work with. Get with a partner. Okay, get with a partner. Get with a partner. Terrific. Everybody partner up. Find a partner. If we got odd numbers, coaches reward. We got partners or odd numbers? Come on. Right down here. Odd. Now, Brooke, right here, please. Brooke. Right here. Who's your partner? Breathe. Brooke, basketball base. Basketball base. Parents, if you're working with your child, this is called a bat three. Come on up, baby. This is the base that a kid should shoot with. Most kids shoot with their feet way too wide. If you look at the absolute best shooters, and I can show you videos of Curry, his feet are tight. Klay Thompson's feet are tight. There's only one shooter that I can think of, the Corver kid, I think it's now with Cleveland. He shoots with a wide base, but he's also 6'9". So we want to be right here. Now, Brooke, tip and rise up, and watch your heels raise the basketball up. So when you finish, do it again. Dip, rise up. Dip, rise up. Just like so. Now, watch what we're going to do. Brooke's got the basketball. Give her the basketball. Now, Bree's back here, and she's going to make a target, just like this. Pay attention to what you have to do, because this is the part that all of you mess up on. I can watch you shoot again and tell you whether or not you're moving. Fingers high, Brooke. Fingers high, thumbs wide. You can do it from up there. Fingers high, thumb wide. Fingers high, thumb wide. Go ahead and do it. Fingers high, thumb wide. Now, the other thing, elbow to the body. Look where Brooke is at. Elbow to the body. Work on it while you're here. Elbow to the body. That's it, Joy. Elbow to the body. So if I go put the basketball in Brooke's pocket, it should be right there, and her thumb is already on the seam. If you get your thumb wide, the ball will end up on the seam. If you hold your thumb like this, and you already know the people who do this, they're going to struggle shooting the basketball. Thumb wide, fingers high. Now, Brooke, get ready. Now, Brooke's going to have hips over heels. Hips. Parents, if you're watching, hips. There's the heels. Hips over heels. Fingers high, thumbs wide. Now, from here, this is her target. That will be you just a second. If she shoots the ball correctly, my hands won't move. Hip. Right in my hands. Now watch the rotation. See, when Brooke shoots with perfect rotation, Brooke is what we call height. Height, money, dip, and reach. Now watch on the finished product. The basketball should come off the floor. Watch Brooke's fingers follow the shot. Follow the shot. Height. Follow the shot. Dip. Now get ready and don't do anything. Once she has the shot loaded, this is what we call shot loaded, fingers up, she's going to dip, and it's a slight flexion of the knees, dip in the hips. And then she's going to go, Brooke, now stay on. High heels. If you don't look like that, you should. If you don't look like that, you should. So mark her up, decide who's going to have the basketball base. Let's work. Let's work. It's on you. Target shoot. Perfect rotation. Tight target. Just like this. Tight target. Thumbs together. Tight target.
That's much better, Zach. Now back up just a little bit. Not too. Come on, work.
Thank you.
If you put your thumb on the inside, it's physically impossible for your thumb to touch the ball. What's your age, you know? Adam. It's my palm touching the ball. But if a kid does it just like this, and her hand is on the inside, it's my palm touching the ball. Yeah, so that means you're shooting the ball off your palm. But if you get your thumb away, you see that? And that's what most of you do, and I keep saying, you're holding it wrong. Brooke passed me the ball too. Now, without me shooting, is my thumb on the seam? Yeah. It makes no difference where Brooke passes the ball. She passes it right there before I shoot. It's my thumb on the seam. Every time. And if you're not shooting it on the seams every time, you're shooting it incorrectly some of the time. And we don't want to do that. Okay? Brooke basketball. Back up, you don't need it. She's right. Going to hop, come up shooting. Bounce, hop, come up shooting. Very good. Back at her. Now stay. This person now has this basketball because this is her target. She shouldn't have to move to catch a basketball. Get the target. Now move left, Brooke. Bounce, hop, come up shooting. Very good. So kids have to learn to bunny hop when they shoot. Brooke again. Now Brooke's going to pound the basketball, bunny hop, come up shooting. Her feet are going to meet the bounce. Hop, come up shooting. Do it again, move it to your left. Bounce, hop, come up shooting. You decide who's doing what. That's the drill you're working on. Let's go.
If you would, Brooke, come on up here, please. Brooke, come on up.
rally, if you would please, elbow away from the body, and I just went up to you and I said, where does the elbow go? And what did y'all say? Elbow goes where? But why wouldn't they put the ball to the body? Because they didn't want to, and it's a habit. Every day that you're walking into the gym, you're creating habits, whether they're good or bad, you're creating habits. If you would get in a habit of getting to the gym and do the things that you need to do, you're going to be amazed how much better you can get. This drill is going to help you. Woman's going to be right here. She's going to have the ball in the shooter's pocket, fingers high, thumbs wide. Lexi and Carrie got slapped out of this. She's going to hop over the cone, toes tight, dip, switch. Dip, switch. Brooke, let's do it again. This is the hot part. Before we go, one of the problems that kids have is Dave and I went to watch a team play last night. Every shooter for this particular team shot on the wrong foot. Their right foot was planted, their left foot moved, and they're right-handed shooters. They didn't do the opposite of the right foot leading. Their left foot left. So somebody has to fix that. The other thing that you have a habit of doing is kids drag their feet when they shoot. If you're moving, you're hopping. If you are standing, you're stepping. If you're moving, you're hopping. If you're standing, you're stepping. But we already know this, don't we, Nicole? It's tough to shoot when you're dragging your foot. Let's hop, follow through. Now watch your dip, roll, please land. Hop, dip, switch. That's good. Now, this is a tall one. She's in the ring. This teaches you that you have to come out of the ring. So she's going to get ready, fingers up, dip, switch, dip, switch. Very good. Dip, switch. One more time. Dip, fingers high. Dip, switch. Now, if you're watching, one kid that missed, this is right on the front of the rim, which is where you're going to miss. So if you shoot straight, eventually you're going to shoot great. Let's get back here. One more time. Now, if she's doing everything correctly, her feet will land, but what's the shot? You focus, and her feet should land outside the ring. Dip. That's very good. And that's where we want to be. When you're working with your child, if you're trying to get better shooting, these are the types of things you want to do. I'm going to put you in a group so that the coach gets to know you. We're going to work for the next hour and 15 minutes on these things. So when I call your name, come to that stage. Hey, yes, you kind of got it? Yes, you don't have it. Yes, we do? No, we don't. Yes, you got it? Eric, show me what we're doing. Sequoia, you know what we're doing? Let's go ahead. Let's work. Let's work. have to speed your feet up to become a great shooter. Y'all slide back so they can see. And coaches, if you're watching and they're not doing it, they're not doing it right. And kids will continue to do things wrong because it's what they want to do. They're okay with not being great. Stay with high. Channel over here. Pop. Swish. Swish. Same catch. Now this time she should have been in the ring. And let you know if you finish with balance. Very good. If you keep working, you are going to be a shooter. Listen to what I'm telling you. If you can shoot it, you get playing time. If you can shoot it, great, you get scholarships. It's really, really simple. Most kids can't shoot because they won't do the things necessary to become a great shooter. Work at it. Ready? Let's play it. Coaches, make them do it.
Thank you.
She goes here, drags her foot back. That's not wrong. Brooke got here, hop back. That makes it quicker. So Nicole, speed it up, hop back. Don't step back. Hard, hard, hard. Roll, drop, 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 hop. Quicker. That's better. That's better. Here we go. Come on, Brooke. Hard. Make that move. Make that move. Step. Hop. Back. Let's go at it, coaches. Let's go. 90 miles an hour. Come on. Work. 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 Cross. One.
Thank you.
chop, step, right foot, and it comes back shooting. The foot opposite the ball is the foot you're going to cut with. So when Nicole's like this, she's going to take that foot hard. And she's not going to bounce the basketball any good. Pulls it back. So Brooke with her left, her right foot's the cut foot, right past the cone. Brooke, I mean, Nicole, go ahead. Hard. Now stutter. Foot. Back. There you go. That was good. That was good. Stutter. Step. Back. Very good. Did y'all see the rotation on that? The perfect rotation. Don't go again. Now, if you watch, all you have to do is create space to soar. Brooke, come here. And coach those to swear. Stay right there, Brooke. Most of you have to have that space to shoot. And you should. Because in rec ball, this is open. JV ball, this is open. For us, where Brooke is at, this is open. She has to get rid of the ball that quick. But my point being to you is that most of you shoot with this stuff they want, so you get ready to shoot. Now, Brooke, go again and come at game speed, chop it more, Brooke. And watch when she takes the right foot. As soon as the right foot's coming back, she's ready to shoot. Go ahead, Brooke. Drop your hip, chop, plant, step, back. I promise you, that's all you need to shoot. Watch Justin Jackson from Carolina. That's all he needs. Nicole, real quick. That quick little jab, back, ready to shoot. All of you, that's all you need. Hard, chop, step, back, ready. Now you see, she moved twice, a little back, and then she popped in. Doesn't make it wrong, but back, back to this, shoot her ready. Coaches, make them work. We got 15 minutes. Now, once she gets here, she turns her shoulder, she's turned over. All right, wait, now go. Come apart. One, two. knock it down, swish. Now once again, grab that basketball, tie it to the bottom. Now coaches, when you're watching this, when they catch this, this is the big part. When they get it right here, long step with the inside foot. One, two, big step. Brooke, go out. Hard. Right here, really quick. Ready, go. So one.
Zero. So the magic number is 21. Shooters, here's what you have to think of. Only have to make one shot in a row. Think swift. You guys keep thinking to shoot. It's not the shot. Make the shot. Don't just take the shot. 2 minutes, coach, is your count.
So I'm here for a while to help you out. I have a fantastic time when I can get into the gym. I go around and I watch different courts. And I see kids trying to do those things, and I want you to understand, don't get frustrated. Good things are gonna happen to people with a good heart who do the right things. They're gonna happen. It's just that way, that's the way I think life works out. I have to say these things, when I came here in 1982, as a teacher, I was an All-American baseball player and I wanted to coach baseball here. The very first year I was here, the principal brought me in the second year, brought me to office and said, we want you to coach basketball. I said, I don't want to coach girls basketball. I said, I'm not asking you if you want to. So back then, if you were a coach, you had to coach. And if you didn't, you lost your teaching position. And of course, I was hungry, so I had a mouth to feed. So I did what he asked. The first year I coached, I didn't know anything about basketball. And when I say nothing, I knew nothing. But the only thing that I did know is I was going to make my kids play hard. We went 16-0. I'm going, it's not bad. Now we couldn't shoot. The second year, we went 19-1. The third year, we went 16-1. And I kind of said, this is way more fun than baseball. Because my first year coaching JV baseball, we went 0-16. And it was cold outside. So I kind of got acclimated to this. And so I decided then, maybe this is what God has called me to do, because sometimes guys make plans and God laughs. So what I thought I wanted was one thing. Where I thought I had a purpose and a plan was a different place. And that's why I feel so fortunate and blessed. So when they gave me the job in 1986, I said, I want to build a program, I don't want to have a team. And of course, if you look at the resume and you're able to do that, you can see what we did. But we didn't do it alone. And I didn't do it. I surrounded myself with great people who could help me help my child, help the kids on my team. We created tutorial programs. We created a standard that our kids had to aspire. I want you to understand this, that I did this. We required this at Central. If you were tarding a class, you had to run 16s for every tard. And we had a guy named Dwayne Waddell that would check attendance each day. When we got here, we set the clock up and you had to run 16s for being late to class. Our kids weren't late to class because they didn't want to run 16s. We created a rule that you could miss 5 days of school from the time school started to the time school was over. There was no excuses to that. In 1999, we had a kid who was a three-time conference, all-conference player. Her senior year, she missed the sixth day on the first day of practice. She comes to me and she says, Coach, me, can't play good. That's our rule. But Coach, you know, I do understand. You can't play. We won a state championship and sitting in the stands was Tamika. Because she had told one of our coaches, well, Coach can't tell me what to do. I'm 18 years old. I'm not going to tell you what to do. I'm going to tell you what you have to do to play here. And so that happened to us three times. And each time that kids made those decisions, it affected their future. Because I said this to someone a while ago, every kid that walked through these doors that I had an opportunity to coach for 4 years got a scholarship. It paid for their education. Education will empower you. It will give you opportunities, and it's given me opportunities beyond my wildest dreams. I never had a thought that I could have the things in my life that I could have. I never thought I could surround myself with people who love my team, our kids, and our program the way that our staff does, the way that we did it then. I only bring this up because I want to give back to you because I feel like I was given to. I want to give back. I want our coaches to help you. So if you're interested in what we have to offer, I want you to be a part of it. I want to help your kids. Our coaches will constantly correct, not constantly criticize. There's a big difference. Even though I know y'all watch me coach, you say, that may be the great, I got it. But if you ever pay attention to what I'm trying to do, as opposed to what I'm trying to say, because I know what we can get our kids to become. And I say this all the time, why do you want to be good if you can be great? Why do you want to be a good parent when you can be a great parent? Why do you want to be a good teacher if you can be a great teacher? So let's aspire to be great, and great things will happen to you. So we get a chance to win some t-shirts. Dave, you show them our choices, and we got the black. So here's the question. And Michael Mack, if you'd stand right here, the first hand you see come up, you point, because I don't want to say, well, that's his favorite. Don't want to do that. There are five F's of shooting.
Gray shirt.
She's got it. Give her 1-2. Her choice of shirt. See if anybody remembers. How many consecutive days does it take to change a habit?
Right here.
30 days, if you would please. Go get you a t-shirt. Give her 1-2. There are three R's of shooting.
Blue shirt, Carolina.
She's got it. Give her 1-2. Now, Michael, kind of stand this way because their hands are going up and we're missing them. Okay?
All right, I'll focus this way.
If you hold it wrong.
Right here.
You shoot it wrong.
You shoot it wrong. Grab your t-shirt. Yeah, she's not going to pick you. It takes this many hours to learn, this many hours to master. Yeah, it takes this many hours right here.
1,000
to learn.
10,000
to master.
Right.
You got to go get you a t-shirt. Very good. Okay. It's not the shots you take.
Great shirt. Everyday training.
It's the shots that you make. Let's give her a 1-2.